Take Rubio Namaga children, today we are going to learn algebra exercise 3.7. So the first question, find the quotient and remainder of the following. So we need to find the quotient and remainder. Okay, here 4x cube plus 6x square minus 23x plus 18 divided by x plus 3. Okay, so we are going to divide this. What is this children? 4x cube plus 6x square minus 23x plus 18 is the dividend. Okay, x plus 3 is the divisor. Here long division method we are going to use. Okay, first write the dividend. 4x cube plus 6x square minus 23x plus 18 divided by x plus 3. Okay, so first step, you take the first term of the dividend, 4x cube, and divide by first term of the divisor. So first term of the divisor is x. So while dividing, what you will get children? X cube by x, here x, 1x, here 2. Okay, because you know the formula, a power m by a power n equal to a power m minus n. So x cube by x equal to x power 3 minus 1. What you will get? X square. So when we divide this, what you are getting? 4x square. So that 4x square you should write in the quotient place. 4x square. What is the first step, children? First, you have to take the first term of the dividend as well as first term of the divisor. Here first term is 4x cube. 4x cube divided by x. Okay. So you cancel this. What you are getting? 4x square. Okay. Now you multiply with the divisor. Okay. So 4x square into x. What you will get children? 4x cube. 4x square into 3. First we multiply the number 3, 4s are 12 into x square. Then you see the sign here plus, so plus into plus, plus. Okay, so now I am going to subtract this. While subtracting only I can cancel this term. Okay, if I want to subtract I have to change this sign. Here positive is there, so you change it as negative. Here positive is there, you change it as negative. Now plus 4x cube minus 4x cube. So cancel this. Here plus 6 minus 12. Plus 6 minus 12, what you will get children? Minus 6x square. Okay. Just x square you just keep it as, just coefficient alone you subtract. Okay. 6 minus 12, you get minus 6. Minus 6, x square. And take the next term, minus 23x. Okay. So, next, what you want to do? You just take the first term of this. Okay. New dividend. So, minus 6, x square by first term of the divisor. What is the first term? X. Okay. So here you cancel this, 2 minus 1, what you will get? 1. So minus 6x. You apply this exponent formula. So x power 2 minus 1, you get x power 1. So x power 1, what children? X only. So minus 6x. Okay. So that you write it in the quotient place. Now you multiply with the divisor. Okay. Minus 6x into x, what you will get children? Minus 6x square. Next, minus into plus, minus 6 3s are 18x. Because 6x is there. 6x into 3 you get 18x. Okay. Now you see here. Both the number have same sign. Same sign means we can't subtract. We can't cancel here. So you want to change the sign. Okay. So plus. Plus. Because we are going to subtract this. Okay. So cancel this now. Minus 6x square plus 6x square. So cancel this. Minus 23x plus 18x. Okay. Yes, here x is common. You just write it. Minus 23 plus 18. What you will get, children? Minus 5. Because 23 is the greater. The sign of the greater number is negative. So that minus 5x. Okay. Next, you take the next term. Plus 18. Okay, children? So now what you will do? Next, what you want to do, children? To take the first term of the u dividend. So minus 5x divided by first term of the divisor x. So xx cancel. What is remaining? Minus 5. So this you should write in the quotient place. Now you multiply with the divisor. Okay. Minus 5 into x, what you will get, children? Minus 5x. Okay. So minus 5 into plus 3, what you will get? Minus 15. Okay. So now I am going to subtract. So I want to change the sign. Minus will change positive. Negative will change positive. Okay. Now cancel this minus 5x plus 5x plus 18 plus 15. What you will get, children? 33. Okay, children. Now what is the quotient? While dividing this, what you are getting? Quotient is? Quotient equal to? 4x square minus 6x minus 5. Remainder equal to? Remainder equal to 33. Do you understand, children? I repeat this. This is long division method. Okay. I am dividing here. First you write the dividend. Okay. After that you write the divisor. Here you take the first term of the dividend and divide the first term of the divisor. What you are getting? 4x square. That you should write in the quotient place. Okay. After that, this number you multiply with the divisor. When you multiply with the divisor, what you are getting? 4x cube plus 12x square. So I want to eliminate this term. How to eliminate this? While subtracting only, I can eliminate. Okay, so I need to change the sign. So your positive is there, it become negative. Positive become negative. Now you cancel this. Okay, plus 6 minus 12, what you will get, children? Minus 6x square. Okay, next take the next term, minus 23x. Okay, after that what you want to do, children? You take the first term of the new dividend and the first term of the divisor. When divide by this, what you are getting, children? Minus 6x. That you should write in the quotient place. Okay. Then you multiply with the divisor. If you multiply with the divisor, what you are getting? Minus 6x square minus 18x. Now I need to change the sign because I want to cancel. Okay. So I change it. My negative becomes positive. Negative becomes positive. So cancel this. While adding, what you are getting? Minus 5x plus 18. So after that, what you want to do, children? The first term of the dividend by first term of the divisor. When we divide this, what you are getting? Minus 5. So then multiply with the divisor. Minus 5 into x. Minus 5x. Minus 5 into 3. You are getting minus 15. Okay. Now you change the sign. After change the sign, to cancel the 5x. After here, both are positive. So, you just add it. What you are getting? 33. Okay. So, So the quotient is 4x square minus 6x minus 5. The remainder is 33. Do you understand, children? See the next one. So minus 18z plus 14z square plus 24z cube plus 18 divided by 3z plus 4. Okay. First, you should arrange the dividend in the descending order. So we have to see the power. Okay. Power you should arrange in descending order. Okay. Here power is 1, 2, 3. Here 0. First, the highest power is 3. Okay, first you write it. 24 z cube plus 14 z square minus 18 z plus 18 divided by 3 z plus 4. Okay. Now you divide this 24z cube plus 14z square minus 18z plus 18 divided by 3z plus 4. What is the first step, children? First, we need to take the first term of the dividend as well as first term of the divisor. So 24z cube divided by 3z. Okay. 3 ones are 3. 3 8s are 24. Z here. You cancel this. Z power 3 minus 1. What you will get, children? Z square. So what is the answer? 8z square. So this one you should write in the quotient place. Okay, now you multiply with the divisor. Okay, so 8 3s are 24, z square into z you will get z cube. Okay, next plus sign is there, plus 8 4s are 32, z square. Now I am going to eliminate this. Okay, if I want to eliminate, I have to change the sign. So positive becomes negative. Cancel this. Plus 14 minus 32. So plus 14 minus 32, what you will get, children? Minus 18z square. Take the next term, minus 18z. What is the next step? We have to take the first term of the new dividend divided by first term of the divisor, 3z. 3 ones are 3, 3 6 are 18. Z square by Z, what you will get, children? Z only. Okay. So, minus 6 Z. Okay. So, this value you should write in the quotient place. Minus 6 Z. Now, you multiply with the divisor. Minus 6 Z into 3 Z, what you will get, children? Minus 18 Z square. Plus into minus? Minus. 6 was the 24z. 24z. Okay. Now, you change the sign. Plus negative becomes positive. Cancel this. Minus 18 plus 24. Okay. What you will get, children? Plus 6z plus 18. Okay. So, now you divide this. 6z by 3z. So 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, z cancel. So what you are getting? 2. So plus 2. Okay. So 2 into 3z you get 6z plus 2 fours are 8. Now change the sign, minus, cancel this, plus 18 minus 8, what you will get, children? Plus 18 minus 8, you get 10. So therefore, quotient is quotient equal to 8 z square minus 6 z plus 2, remainder equal to 10. Remainder equal to 10. You understand, children? The quotient is 8 z square minus 6 z plus 2. Remainder is 10. The area of a rectangle is x square plus 7x plus 12. If its breadth is x plus 3, then find its length. Okay? Here, what is given, children? Area of a rectangle is given. Breadth is given. We need to find out the length. Okay? First, write the formula, children. Area of a rectangle, what is the formula? Area of a rectangle equal to length into breadth square unit. Okay, here area of a rectangle is x square plus 7x plus 12 equal to length we are going to find, just keep it as it is, into breadth value x plus 3. Okay, so we are going to find length. So x square plus 7x plus 12 divided by x plus 3 equal to length. So length equal to what is the formula? Area divided by breadth. Here breadth is multiplication. So multiplications will change other side, divisions. So how we are going to find length? So area divided by breadth, we are going to find length. Okay, now you divide this using the long division. You divide this x square plus 7x plus 12 divided by x plus 3. Okay, you first take the first term of the dividend. So x square by first term of the divisor x. When we divide this, what you are getting, children? X. So you write it in the quotient place. So x into x, x square plus x into 3, 3x. Okay, now change the sign, children. So cancel this. 7x minus 3x. What you will get, children? 4x plus 12. Now you take first term of the new dividend by the first term of the divisor. So cancel the x. What you are getting? 4. So 4, you write it in the quotient place, plus 4. 4 into x, you get 4x plus 4, 3 is a 12. Now you change the sign, children. So cancel this. Both the terms are cancelled. So what you are getting? 0. So what is the length, children? Therefore, length equal to x plus 4. What is the length? Length equal to x plus 4. Okay, children? Length equal to area divided by breadth. So, we divided this. When we divide this, what we are getting? X plus 4. Is it clear, children? See the next one. The base of a parallelogram is 5x plus 4. So, base equal to 5x plus 4. Find its height. So, what we are going to find? Height. So, height we are going to find. Then the area is 25x square minus 16. So, area of a parallelogram equal to 25 x square minus 16. Okay, children. So first write the formula. So area equal to area of a parallelogram equal to base into height square units. Here area is 25 x square minus 16 equal to base is 5x plus 4 into height. So we are going to find height. Okay, so height, I don't just keep it here. Height equal to area divided by base. So 25 x square minus 16 divided by base 5x plus 4. Okay, here you divide this by using long divisions or factorizations. Okay, I'm going to use factorizations because here square is there, we can able to convert this also square numbers. Okay, so that I'm using factorization method. Okay, so 25 x square, how can you write, children? 5x the whole square. When we square this number, what you will get? 25 x square minus 4 square divided by 5x plus 4 equal to height. Okay, now look at this. Here, see here, 5x square minus 4 is it is in the form of a square minus b square equal to a plus b into a minus b. Okay, so here a equal to 5x, b equal to 4. Okay, so how can you write this? 5x plus 4, 5x minus 4 divided by 5x plus 4 equal to height. Okay, so 5x plus 4, 5x plus 4 cancel. So what is remaining? So height equal to five x minus 4. You understand, children? So height equal to 5x minus 4. Is it clear, children? See the next one. The sum of x plus 5 observations is x cube plus 125. Find the mean of the observations. So we are going to find the mean. Okay, first write the formula. Mean equal to sum of observations divided by number of observations. Okay, here the sum of observation is x cube plus 125 divided by number of observation is x plus 5. Okay, so we are going to find mean. So you want to divide this. Okay, the sum of x plus 5 observations, this is number of observation is x plus 5. The sum of the observation is x cube plus 125. While dividing this, we are getting the mean. Okay, here long division method we are going to use. But see the power here, x cube. X cube, after that, what term should be there? X square. So the x square is not there. Even x also is not there. So what do you want to do? Just replace this x cube plus 0x square plus 0x plus 125 divided by x plus y. Okay, first you replace like this. Okay, because x square and x term is 0. So that we are mentioning here. Okay, now you divide this x cube plus 0x square plus 0x plus 125 divided by x plus 5. Take the first term of the dividend x cube divided by first term of the divisor x. While dividing this, what you are getting? X square. This one you should write in the quotient place. Now you multiply this x square into x, what you will get, children? X cube. Then plus 5 into x square, 5x square. Now I am going to subtract, so change the sign. So cancel this. 0 minus 5, what you will get? Minus 5x square plus 0x. Okay, here, so take the first term of the new dividend, minus 5x square divided by x. X square by x, what you will get, children? X only. So, minus 5x. Okay, minus 5x. Multiply this, minus 5x square plus into minus minus 5 is 25x. Now, change the sign. Positive, positive. Cancel this. So what you will get? 25x plus 125. Okay. Now take the first term of the new dividend. 25x. 25x divided by x. Xx cancel. So plus 25. Plus 25 into x, you get 25x plus 25 into 5, 125. I'll change the sign. So cancel. Both the terms are cancelled. So what you are getting remainder? 0. Okay. So what is the quotient? X square minus 5x plus 25. When we divide this, what we are getting? X square minus 5x plus 25. So therefore, mean equal to x square minus 5x plus 25. Do you understand, children? Thank you, children.